Hi, PhotoPiller. In this video, you will learn how to use the geodesic information to find out if the sun and moon will be visible or hidden by an obstacle. You can find the geodesic information on this panel. It gives us information about the relative altitudes between the observer's pin and the obstacle's pin. You can make the obstacle's pin appear by tapping on this button. The obstacle is represented by this black pin. Place the obstacle's pin on a hill, a mountain, or any obstacle you think can hide the sun or the moon. For example, let's place it on this mountain. The information of the top panel is automatically recalculated. This is the distance between the observer's pin and the obstacle's pin, 613.8 meters. The azimuth measured from the north between the two pins is 113.1 degrees. The relative altitude between the pins, 153 meters, and the relative elevation, 14 degrees. The observer's pin is located at an altitude of 192 meters above sea level, and the obstacle's pin at an altitude of 345 meters above sea level. The relative altitude, that is, the difference between altitudes, is, therefore, 153 meters. The distance between the two pins is 613.8 meters, and the elevation of the obstacle's pin relative to the observer's pin is 14 degrees. Let's see it on a picture. If we do a section cut by the white dotted line connecting the two pins, we get this picture. The observer's pin is located at an altitude of 192 meters above sea level, and the obstacle's pin at an altitude of 345 meters above sea level. The difference of altitudes tells us that the obstacle has an altitude of 153 meters above the observer's pin. The distance between the two pins is 613.8 meters. Taking into account the curvature of the Earth, the elevation of the obstacle's pin relative to the observer's pin is 14 degrees. Now, if we move time, we will be able to know if the sun and the moon will be visible when they are aligned with the obstacle. When the sun or the moon are hidden by the obstacle, the azimuth line becomes dotted. Let's move time and place the sun so it's aligned with the mountain. As you see, the mountain will hide the sun because the azimuth line of the sun is dotted. Let's check it. The relative elevation between pins is 14 degrees. The elevation of the sun at this time is 11.4 degrees. This is less than 14 degrees, and therefore, the mountain will hide the sun. Let's have a look at the picture. We know that the elevation of the sun at this time is 11.4 degrees, which is less than the relative elevation between the observer's pin and the obstacle's pin, which is 14 degrees. Therefore, the mountain will hide the sun. Let's continue moving time to find out if the moon will be visible when aligned with the mountain. As you can see, the azimuth line is not dotted. Therefore, the moon will be visible. Let's check it. The relative elevation between pins is 14 degrees, as you know. The elevation of the moon at this time is 36.5 degrees. This is greater than 14 degrees, and therefore, the moon will be visible. Again, let's have a look at the picture. We know that the elevation of the moon at this time is 36.5 degrees, which is greater than the relative elevation between the observer's pin and the obstacle's pin, which is 14 degrees. Therefore, you can see on the picture that the mountain will not hide the moon. That's all, PhotoPiller. Thanks for watching.